بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا من سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أتممنا ولله الحمد والمنة في الدرس السابق ما يتعلق بالناقض الثالث من نواقض الإسلام، نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى العافية والسلامة. نعم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا وسلم. So in the previous lesson we finished by the virtue and the kindness of Allah, that which relates to the third matter which invalidates a person's Islam, and we ask for Allah's safety and pardoning.
نعم. أما الناقض الأول فهو الشرك في عبادة الله.
So the first matter which invalidates a person's Islam is a shirk, ascribing partners in the worship of Allah.
وقصد بهذا الشرك الأكبر، لأن كل من صرف شيء من العبادة لغير الله فهو مشرك شرك أكبر.
And he intends by this, the author intended by this, shirk akbar, the major form of shirk. So whomsoever does an action which is shirk akbar, then he has left the fold of Islam.
وإذا قال،
and if a person says
أنه لا يريد عبادة هؤلاء، يريد منهم القربة والشفاعة ويتوكل عليهم، فهذا هو الناقض الثاني من نواقض الإسلام، وهو الذي كان عليه الكفار الذين بعث فيهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، أي بعض الكفار. نعم.
So if a person says that I'm not actually worshipping that object, rather I'm just directing these actions towards that object or towards that person, so that person can take me closer to Allah, or so that person or that object can act as an intercession for me on behalf with Allah, then this is the exact shirk, and this is the disbelief of the disbelievers at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
نعم. أما الناقض الثالث،
as for the third matter which invalidates a person's Islam،
من لم يكفر المشركين أو شك في كفرهم أو توقف أو تردد أو قال أنا لا أقول عنهم شيء أو صحح مذهبهم وقال أن الذي عليه هو حق ودين، منذ أن بعث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نسخ كل شريعة كانت قبل، والذي بلغته دعوة محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولم يؤمن به فهو كافر كائنا من كان، يهودي أو نصراني أو مجوسي وغيره. نعم.
So the third matter which invalidates a person's Islam is for somebody who to not consider one of the disbelievers as being a disbeliever, or to doubt in their disbelief, or to be unsure of their disbelief, or to say that I don't take a position, neither do I say they're believers, neither do I say they are disbelievers, or for a person to say that their ideology or their madhab or their way is correct. So the Sharia of Islam, when it came, it abrogated all the previous religions, all the previous religions. So anybody to whom the message of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was conveyed and he doesn't accept this, then this person is a disbeliever, whoever this person may be, a Jew or a Christian, anybody.
نعم. أما ما يتعلق ببقية النواقض فنكملها إن شاء الله تعالى في هذا الوقت، وكذلك بعد العشاء، نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى التوفيق والسداد. نعم.
And as for the rest of the remainder of the matters which invalidate a person's Islam, then we will complete them in the remaining time between now and Isha and that which is after Isha. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for التوفيق and the sadat.
قال في القاع في الناقض الرابع من نواقض الإسلام.
So he said, I the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he said regarding the fourth matter which invalidates a person's Islam, he said, whoever believes that the guidance of somebody other than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is more perfect than the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or the laws of other than the Prophet are better than the laws of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, like the person who prefers or gives preference to the laws of the tawaghit, such a person has disbelieved.
نعم. هذه المسألة أو هذا الناقض من نواقض الإسلام فيه أن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام كان يكرر هذا في خطبه عليه الصلاة والسلام، وخير الهدي هدي محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة.
So this matter which invalidates a person's Islam, this contains a message that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would repeat and emphasize during all his sermons, when he used to say that the best of guidance is the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and also the saying of Allah subhanahu wa taala, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ, indeed there is for you, فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ, in the Messenger of Allah, أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ, a good model or a good example.
مثال هذا أو على ما ذكر المؤلف رحمه الله من اعتقد أن غير هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أكمل من هدي عليه الصلاة والسلام, هذا إن اعتقد فقد أتى بناقض من نواقض الإسلام, وبهذا خرج نسأل الله السلام العافية من الإسلام إلى الكفر.
So an example of this, or to use that which the author mentioned, is for somebody to believe that the guidance of other than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is better or more perfect than the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So if anybody has this belief, then this person has fallen to that which invalidates his Islam.
وهذا في الغالب أنه يحصل من بعض الناس هدانا الله إياهم في العمل, لكن قد يؤدي هذا العمل إلى الاعتقاد, وإذا أدى إلى الاعتقاد دخل في الكفر الأكبر.
So this matter, it often occurs from some people in terms of their actions. May Allah guide them and guide us. However, if this action of theirs, if it then necessitates a belief, then this belief would exit them for the fall of Islam.
بعض الناس يعجب مثلا بعالم من العلماء, إمام من الأئمة. نعم.
Some people are amazed by a scholar or an imam from amongst the imams.
فيقول مثلا,
so for example he says,
في مسألة خالف فيها هذا الإمام ما جاء عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
So he says in a matter in which the imam has gone against the saying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
يقول أصاب الإمام وأخطأ النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
He says that the imam was correct, however the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made an error.
أو يقول هذا الإمام في هذه المسألة هدي أكمل من هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, وهو أفضل وأحسن وأعلم وما إلى ذلك, فإن اعتقد كفر كفر أكبر, نسأل الله السلامة العافية.
Or he says that the guidance of this imam is better than the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, or it's more noble or more virtuous or more important, or other words similar to this, than the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So if this person said this, if he believes this in his heart, then he has disbelieved with a major form of disbelief.
نعم. ولهذا أكثر الأئمة رحمهم الله تعالى من الكلام في هذا الباب ومن التحذير من التقليد, لأنه قد يؤدي إلى هذا, إلى الاعتقاد, وإذا أدى للاعتقاد فأي في أن هدي أي أحد أكمل من هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فقد أتى بناقض من نواقض الإسلام. نعم.
And for this reason, many of the scholars, many of the great imams, the great scholars of Islam, they mentioned or they warned against at-taqlid, blind following. So that person is cautious that he doesn't fall into this type of action. I saying that the guidance of a person, any person, other than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is better than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And therefore, he commits an act which invalidates his Islam.
نعم. فقبل أن تصل إلى هذا أي إلى الاعتقاد لابد أن تحرص على هذا في العمل. مثاله,
so before this action of his reaches or becomes a belief, the person has to pay attention to his action. An example of this is,
ورد دعاء كان يدعو به إمام من الأئمة مثلا.
So for example, let's say if there's a supplication that one of the great scholars used to supplicate by.
فماذا تصنع؟ تقول خير الهدي هدي محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام.
So what do you say? You say the best of guidance is the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هل دعا عليه الصلاة والسلام بهذا الدعاء؟
Did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم supplicate with this supplication?
نعم, إذا دعا بهذا الدعاء نقول هذا هو هدي النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام وأمرنا باتباعه.
So if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam supplicated with the same supplication that this imam did, then we say that yes, this is from the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we follow him.
وإن لم يأتي نترك ما جاء عن غير النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ونرجع إلى هدي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And if the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't supplicate, didn't make dua with the supplication of this imam or this scholar, then we leave alone this supplication, and rather we supplicate with the supplication that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم came with.
بعض الناس له طريقة مثلا في التعليم أو إلى الدعوة إلى الله. نعم. فهل نقدم هذه الطريقة على ما جاء عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام؟ لا. نقول خير الهدي هدي محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام. نعم. وعلى هذا تسير.
Some people, they have a way or a manner or methodology of giving da'wah. Or they have a way or a methodology of teaching, for example. But do we give preference to this methodology or this way more than that of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam? No. Rather, we follow the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam.
ثم ذكر ضمن هذا الناقض ما يتعلق بحكم النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And then the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentioned within this matter which invalidates a person's Islam, the rules or the laws of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam.
الحكم بغير ما أنزل الله.
Ruling by other than that which Allah has revealed.
إذا اعتقد أن الحكم بغير ما أنزل الله مثل حكم الله أو أحسن أو أن حكم الله لا يصلح فإن اعتقد كفر كفر أكبر مخرج من الملة.
If a person has the belief that the rules or the laws of other than Allah are better than the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or they are equal to the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or that the laws of Allah and the rules of Allah, they don't apply to a particular time or a particular place. If he believes this, then this person has committed an act of major disbelief, kufr akbar.
Ahsan.
So if he says it is better, meaning the rules of other than Allah better than the rules of Allah,
أو مساوي,
or equal to the laws of Allah,
أو أن حكم الله لا يصلح,
or that the laws of Allah, they don't apply.
إذا كان هذا عن اعتقاد فهو كفر أكبر.
So if this is belief, then this is major disbelief.
لكن
أكبر.
إن قدم حكم القوانين أو الطواغيت لهوى في نفسه أو حب رياسة أو منصب مع اعتقاد أن حكم الله هو الأنفع والأصلح للبلاد والعباد فهذا كفر أصغر أي كفر دون كفر.
But if a person believes that the laws and the rules of Allah are better, if a person believes that the rules and the laws of Allah, they're more appropriate and more beneficial for the people and the places or the countries, but he uses the laws of the disbelievers, or he uses the laws of other than Allah due to a desire in his heart, or due to wanting authority or governance or leadership, then this person has committed an act of disbelief, however it is a minor form of disbelief. Kufr duna kufr. Not the major disbelief, but rather the minor disbelief.
Kufr duna kufr, ay kufr asghar, wa mushik an yaqa' fil kufr al-akbar. Wa labud an yuhadhar wa khawaf billah. Na'am.
So this person who has done this, then he has committed kufr asghar, a minor form of kufr, a disbelief, and not a major form of disbelief. However, it's feared that he's going to enter into kufr akbar, major disbelief. And therefore, this person has to be warned. And this person has to be made scared of this action of his.
نعم. إذن إن اعتقد في غير هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أو في غير حكم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مع الاعتقاد فقد كفر كفر أكبر نسأل الله السلامة والعافية. نعم.
So therefore, if a person rules by or if a person holds the guidance of other than the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, or the rules of Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi, or other than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to be better than the guidance or the rules or the laws of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with this disbelief, then he has committed major kufr.
بعض الناس هدانا الله إياه يظن أن تطبيق الشريعة وتطبيق الحكم بما أنزل الله خاص بالرؤساء والقضاة.
Some people, may Allah guide them and guide us, they think that applying or implementing the rules and the laws of Allah, this is just for the rulers, just for the leaders.
ولا يدري أن كل واحد لابد أن يطبق الشريعة
And this person doesn't know that every single person has to implement the Sharia.
يطبق الشريعة على نفسه.
He has to implement the Sharia upon himself.
وكذلك مع أولاده وزوجته وكل المجتمع الذي هو فيه.
And also his children, his wife, and the society that he is in.
فإذا حكمنا الشريعة في كل أمور الحياة لا نحتاج أصلا إلى قضاء. لو كل واحد منا عرف الذي له والذي عليه لا نحتاج إلى قضاء. لكن الإشكال كل الإشكال عندما لا تطبق الشريعة نحتاج إلى من يلزم هؤلاء بتطبيق الشريعة. نعم.
So if every single one of us was to implement the Sharia and apply the Sharia or the rules of Allah, then we wouldn't need judges or Islamic courts, because when people, or when every single one, when each of us doesn't apply the rules and the Sharia and implement the Sharia of Allah, then we need other people, either judges and the courts, to force people to then implement, apply the Sharia of Allah.
هل حاجة الناس اليوم للقضاء مثل حاجة الناس أيام السلف الصالح؟ لا. كل ما بعد الناس عن الشريعة كل ما احتاجوا إلى من يلزلهم بتطبيقها. نعم.
Is the need of the people today for judges and courts like the need of the people previously at the time of the Salaf? No. In every instance or in every time whereby people they distance themselves or they go farther away from the Sharia of Allah, then they are in more need of people who will come and oblige and force them to implement and apply the Sharia of Allah.
نعم. هذا ما يتعلق بهذا الناقض ولا بد أن نحكم الشريعة.
So therefore this is what relates to this matter which invalidates a person's Islam, and we have to implement the Sharia.
يبدأ الإنسان بالعمل قبل أن يقع في الاعتقاد. على ما ذكرنا في الهدي كذلك نذكر في الحكم. نعم.
So a person has to begin by implementing this in his actions before he starts going back to his beliefs. And the same thing which we have mentioned regarding the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we mentioned the same thing about the rules and the laws of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
فلا بد أن نقف عند حدود الله.
So therefore, we have to stop or we have to limit ourselves according to the laws and the boundaries and the limits of Allah.
Abu Mas'ud رضي الله عنه. Abu Mas'ud وهو غير ابن مسعود رضي الله عنهم.
Abu Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him, and he is other than Ibn Mas'ud, the companion رضي الله عنه.
يقول كنت أضرب غلام لي.
He says that I used to hit a servant of mine.
يعني عبد مملوك.
Meaning a slave that he used to own.
فسمعت صوتا من خلفي.
So then I heard a voice from behind me.
يعني هناك من كان من خلفه يقول له.
Meaning there was somebody who was behind him who was, and he said to him.
لله أقدر عليك من قدرتك على هذا.
That Allah has more ability over you than your ability over this slave. Meaning Allah has more ability and more control over you than the control and the ability you have over your slave.
قال فالتفت فإذا هو رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So Abu Mas'ud رضي الله عنه says, I turned around and it is the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم.
من الذي يذكر الآن بالله؟ النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Who is the one who is now reminding him of Allah? It is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
والصحابة رضي الله عليهم كانوا يقفوا عند حدود الله.
And the companions, they would stop at the rules, the laws, the limits of Allah.
لم يعترض.
They never opposed.
أو يقول يا رسول الله عليه الصلاة والسلام هو صنع كذا وكذا وكذا.
And they would never say, or he never said that, oh Messenger of Allah, this slave, he did this and he did this and he did this.
مجرد أن سمع هذا التذكير من النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
As soon as he heard this reminder from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قال يا رسول الله هو حر لوجه الله.
He said, oh Messenger of Allah, this person is free for the sake of Allah.
إذن.
And therefore.
تطبيق الشريعة.
Implementing the Sharia.
يكون على كل أحد.
It is upon every single individual.
نعم. بعد هذا.
And then after this,
بالناقض الخامس من نواقض الإسلام. نعم.
And after this, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he mentioned the fifth matter which invalidates a person's Islam.
فقال. نعم.
So he said, رحمه الله, fifth, if a person hates or detests anything which the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم came with, even if the person performs the action. Such a person has disbelieved.
يقول من أبغض شيئا. أبغض شيئا شيئا هنا تعم كل شيء قليل أو كثير.
So the author رحمه الله, he said that whomsoever hates or detests anything, and anything meaning everything, whether it's little or large.
مما جاء به النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام أي من الشريعة كاملة.
From that which the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم came with, meaning from all of the شريعة.
ولو كان يعمل بهذا الشيء فهو كافر كفر أكبر, نسأل الله السلام العافية.
Even if a person does this action or performs this action, then a person has committed major disbelief. He's a kafir.
مثال هذا.
An example of this is
يبغض الصلاة.
That a person, he detests or hates the prayer.
ولو كان يصلي وهو مبغض للصلاة فهو كافر كفر أكبر, نسأل الله السلام العافية.
So even if a person prays and yet he hates or detests the prayer, then this person is a disbeliever who has committed a major form of disbelief, and we ask Allah for safety and pardoning.
لأن
because
المحبة,
because loving
تكون للعمل والعامل والأزمنة والأمكنة.
Because the love that a person has to be for the action, for the person who does the action, for the time and the place.
والبغض يكون للعمل والعامل والأزمنة والأمكنة.
And also hatred has to be for the action and the person who performs the action and the time and the place.
يحب العمل.
A person loves an action.
كل ما جاءت به الشريعة لابد أن يحب كل ما جاء أو أمر به الله سبحانه وتعالى أو أمر به النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. فلا وربك لا يؤمنون حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم ثم لا يجدوا في أنفسهم حرجا لا قليل أو كثير مما قضيت ويسلم وتسليما. نعم.
So a person has to love every single action in the Sharia, meaning every single action which the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with, or every single action or order which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered with. Like Allah says in the Quran, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ. No, by Allah. لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. They do not believe حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ. They do not believe up until they make you as a judge, i.e. you the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a judge in those things which they differ in. And after, the meaning of the ayah is that after the judge, the ruling of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has been passed, فَلَا يَجِدُونَ فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا
ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُونَ
ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُونَ. Then they do not feel in their hearts any form of haraj, meaning any form of haraj, sajad, any form of displeasure or any form of restriction in their heart.
لا قليل ولا كثير.
A little amount or a lot.
إذا لابد من محبة العمل أي محبة كل ما جاء في الشريعة.
And therefore, from what the Sheikh mentioned, that loving the action, meaning that you love every single thing which the Sharia came with.
ويقابل هذا كل ما حرم الشارع لابد من بغضه.
And the opposite to this is that everything which the Shari, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, everything that they have made impermissible, then you have to detest and hate this.
الشارع هو الله سبحانه وتعالى والنبي عليه الصلاة والسلام وبلغ عن الله. نعم.
So the meaning of Shari, either the one who legislates, is, as I mentioned, Allah or His Messenger, or the one who conveys anything from Allah and His Messenger.
نعم. يبغض الشرك.
So a person has to hate and detest الشرك
والربا,
and also riba, usury and interest,
والزنا وغير هذا من المحرمات,
and زنا, adultery, and all those other things which are impermissible.
يحب كل ما أمر به الشارع الحكيم سبحانه وتعالى.
So a person has to love everything which the legislator, i.e. Allah and His Messenger, in their wisdom, they ordered with or they legislated.
الصلاة والصيام والحج والزكاة وغير هذا.
Prayer, fasting, الزكاة, حج, and other than these matters.
الثاني محبة العمل, العامل.
And then the second thing is a person loving the person who performs the action.
الأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
The messengers and the prophets عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
الملائكة.
The angels.
الصالحين.
The righteous people.
كل موحد يحب ولا بد في الله.
every single person who is upon at-tawheed, every single person who is upon tawheed, he has to be loved.
بغض.
And I'll say it, I'm hating
للعامل.
The person forms an action.
Iblis.
For example, Iblis.
Kuffar.
The disbelievers.
أهل النفاق. السلام العافية.
The people of hypocrisy, we ask Allah for safety and pardoning.
كل كافر.
Every disbeliever.
محبة أزمن يحبها الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And also loving those times which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves.
ثلث الليل الآخر.
For example, loving the last third of the night.
ليلة القدر.
The night of Al-Qadr.
Ramadan.
Loving Ramadan.
وغير هذا.
And the other times.
بغض أزمنة.
And also hating certain times.
يحتفل بالكفار مثلا بأعيادهم كعيد رأس السنة.
So for example, hating the times or the festivals that the non-Muslims and the disbelievers celebrate, such as the New Year.
محبة أمكنة يحبها الله.
And also loving those places which Allah loves.
المساجد.
The mosques.
مكة.
مكة.
المدينة.
مدينة.
وغير هذا.
And other places.
بغض أمكنة.
And also hating certain places.
يبغضها الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Those places which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hates and detests.
أماكن الشرك.
The places of shirk.
والمعاصي.
The places of disobedience.
مسجد ضرار.
A masjid that was built in order to harm the Muslims.
نعم. وغير هذا.
And other places that Allah
hates. إذن هذا الناقض في من أبغض الشيء قليل أو كثير.
So therefore this matter, i.e. this naqid, the matter which invalidates Islam, is somebody hating anything, whether it be a large amount, small amount.
قال ولو عمل به كفر كمن أبغض الصلاة وهو محافظ على الصلاة المفروضة. نعم.
So this matter relates to hating anything which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with. If you hate anything which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with, even if you perform that action, then this is major disbelief. Like, for example, the person who hates the prayer and yet he observes every single one of his prayers. He prays every single one of his prayers. This person is a disbeliever.
نعم. حتى وإن كان هذا البغض للصلاة النافلة للفريضة.
Even if this person he hated the voluntary prayers, not the obligatory prayers.
لأن هذا فيه اعتراض على شرع الله سبحانه وتعالى. نعم.
Because this shows a rejection or turning away from the Sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
فلا بد أن تحب الله.
So therefore you have to love Allah.
ولا يمكن أن تحب شيء مع الله.
And it's not possible for you to love anything along with Allah.
وتحب كل من أمر الله بحبه.
And that you love every single person whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered for you to love.
عمل.
Or anything such as an action.
وعامل.
Or the person does the action.
وأزمنة وأمكنة.
Or times or places.
نعم. بعد هذا.
And then after this, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, mentioned the sixth matter which invalidates a person's Islam.
هذا الناقض من النواقض التي ذكرنا أن النواقض تجتمع في أربعة أشياء. إما قول أو عمل أو اعتقاد أو شك. هذا ناقض عظيم ويقع فيه بعض الناس هدانا الله وإياه وهو الاستهزاء. نعم.
So this matter which invalidates a person's Islam, the next one that I'm going to read, this is something which many people fall into, and it goes back to an action which invalidates a person's heart, a person's Islam, whether it's a statement or an action or a belief.
No.
So the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, sixth, a person who makes mockery of something which is from the religion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or makes mockery of its rewards or punishments, such a person has disbelieved. وَالدَّلِيلْ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, and the evidence for this is the saying of Allah the Most High, قُلْ, say, أَبِاللَّهِ, was it at Allah, وَآيَاتِهِ, and his signs, and his messenger, that he used to make mockery of? لَا تَعْتَذِرُوا, do not make any excuse. قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ, indeed you have disbelieved after your belief and faith.
الاستهزاء سخر واستهزى ورآه لعبا وليس بجد. نعم هذا هو الاستهزاء
so,
يسخر ويستهزئ ويرى أن هذا الشيء ليس بجد بل أنه من اللعب
So the meaning of istihza, which is the name of this matter, means to mock something or make mockery of something or treat something very, very lightly as if it's just some type of play. All of this comes under al-istihza, a mockery.
Al-kufr ينقسم إلى قسمين.
Disbelief is of two types.
Kufr i'rab wa kufr mu'arada. Kufr i'rab بأن لا يدخل في الدين لكن لا يتعرض للدين بالسب والشتم كما حصل من أبي طالب
So disbelief is of two types The first type of disbelief is كفر الإعراض Meaning a person just turns away from the religion So a person insults religion opposes the religion go against religion but he just turns away from it Meaning he chooses not to believe like the action of Abu Talib the uncle of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
الثاني كفر معارضة يعارض ويقف ضد الإسلام ويحارب ويسب ويشتم ويستهزئ ويسخر كما حصل من أئمة الكفر أبو جهل مثلا نعم
And the second form of disbelief is كفر المعارضة meaning a person who stubbornly rejects insults, mocks the religion of Allah like that which occurred from the leaders of disbelief such as Abu Jahl
هذا الذي يستهزئ بالكتاب أو بالسنة أو يسب الرب أو يسب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أو أحد من الأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام نعم
So this person who makes mockery of Allah or his messenger Or he insults the religion, or the Lord, or the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
أو بآيات الله الكونية أو الشرعية.
Or a person who makes mockery of the signs of Allah, whether these signs are physical and universal, or whether these are signs of Islam, i.e. in the Quran.
فهو كافر كفر أكبر نسأل الله السلام العافية.
So this type of person is a disbeliever with the major form of disbelief, and we ask Allah for safety and pardoning.
وكفر هذا
And the disbelief of this person
كفر معارضة مثل ما حصل من أبو لهب وأبو جهل نعم لأنه يسب ويستهزئ كيف يسب ويستهزئ ويسخر بأحق الحق قل أبي الله يعني ما بقي أن تسخر وتستهزئ وتلعب إلا بالله وآياته ورسوله نعم
So this person, the one who mocks something from the religion or insults the religion or Allah or his messenger or mocks the messenger his kufr, his disbelief is the kufr of mu'arada the kufr of insulting and mocking and insulting Allah Why? And this is the most severe form of disbelief Why? Because this person is mocking the most truthful of truths Like Allah says in the Quran, قُلْ أَبِ اللَّهِ Say that at Allah and his ayat, his verses, and his messenger used to mock at.
يعني ما بقي لكم أي من كان يوجه لهم هذا الخطاب ما بقي لهم إلا أن يلعبوا بالكتاب وبالسنة وتكلموا في الأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام وفي رب العزة
meaning those people who mocked Allah and his messenger those people who addressed in this ayah was there nothing else left for them that they could mock was there nothing else left that they could mock except that they had to mock Allah and his verses and his messenger
هذه المسألة مسألة مهمة جدا
so this issue is a very or this issue is a very very important issue
لأن هناك من يمزح
because some people there exist some people who joke
ويأتي أحيانا حتى بأمور حتى يضحك بها الناس من الكتاب والسنة
This matter is very very important, very very dangerous because some people they use things from the Quran and from the Sunnah in order to make people laugh
فإذا كانت المسألة واضحة بينة
So if the issue is clear and apparent
سب للرب
For example a person insults the Lord Allah
أو للنبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Or person insults the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام.
أو بآيات الله سبحانه وتعالى.
Or person insults the verses of Allah.
فهذه مسألة واضحة جدا.
So then this issue, this ruling is clear and apparent.
فهذا كافر كفر أكبر مخرج من الملة.
This person has disbelieved with a major form of disbelief and he's left the fold of Islam.
وإذا تكلم إنسان.
But if a person talks
بشيء أو ذكر حديث وضحك الناس.
But if a person he says a hadith in order to make people laugh,
ننبه هذا ونحذره أن هذا استهزاء وكفر.
Then we have to warn this person, and we have to guide this person. We say to him that look, this is mockery and this is disbelief.
فإن
so if
رجع
if this person repents and returns,
تركناه.
Then we leave him alone.
وإن أصر على اللعب بنصوص الكتاب والسنة والاستهزاء كفرنا.
If, however, this person continues and persists upon making a joke of the ayat of the Quran and the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then this person is considered as a disbeliever.
من العجب.
From the strange things.
لا تسمع أحد من أهل الكتاب.
That you never find a person from the people of the book.
يسب الرب.
Ever insulting the Lord Allah.
أو يسب أحد من أنبياء أهل الكتاب موسى أو عيسى عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
Or you never find anyone from amongst the people of the book ever insulting the prophets of the Jews or the Christians, meaning موسى عليه السلام وعيسى عليه السلام.
مع أننا نعرف ما هم عليه من يعني ترك الدين وغير هذا.
Even though we know what they are upon in terms of leaving the religion.
لكن تجد.
But you find.
وإلى الله المشتكى.
And to Allah is the complaint.
من يدعي أنه من أهل الإسلام.
You find a person who claims to be from the people of Islam.
ويسب الرب.
And yet he insults the Lord Allah.
عيانا جهارا ليلا نهارا.
He insults him specifically, insults him in the open in front of everybody.
بل عندما سب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من بعض الناس في بعض الدول الكافرة.
Rather, when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was mocked and insulted in some of the countries of disbelief,
خرج بعض الناس في مظاهرات.
Some people they came out in demonstrations, demonstrating.
دفاعا عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Defending or in defense of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
المظاهرات لا تمت للإسلام بالصلاة كما قال هذا الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله تعالى. يعني ليس لها علاقة بالإسلام المظاهرات.
So these demonstrations, as Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah mentioned, they have no relationship to Islam.
الشاهد.
The point is.
أن هؤلاء خرجوا في مظاهرات للدفاع عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
That those people they came out in demonstration for the defense of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وكان فيهم.
And amongst them was.
من يسب الرب.
A person who insults the Lord.
وخرج في مظاهرات ضد من يسب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And yet this person, he comes out demonstrating against those people who insult the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
من أولى بالإنكار؟
Who is the one who is more appropriate of being forbidden or spoken against?
أولى هذا لأنه هذا يدعي الإسلام.
The first person who should be spoken against is this person because he claims for himself Islam.
ثم بعض الناس يدافع عن هؤلاء.
And then some people, they defend those people.
ويقول أن هذا عندما يغضب يسب.
And they say that these Muslims who insult, or they came to be Muslims and they insult Allah, that they're only doing this when they become very angry.
طيب لماذا عندما يغضب لا يسب والده مثلا؟
So why is it that when this person becomes angry, why doesn't he insult his own father?
أو لا يسب الرئيس.
Or he doesn't insult the leader or the ruler.
والله لا يتجرأ أن يسب أقل فرد من أفراد هذا الرئيس ولو كان جندي صغير لأنه يخاف من السجن. أما في سب الرب يسب ولا يبالي.
By Allah, the lowest level of soldier, the lowest rank of soldier, he doesn't have the courage and he doesn't dare to insult his ruler. Why? Because he's scared of the punishment of being imprisoned. And yet, when it comes to insulting Allah, then they do this and they don't care.
إذن
and therefore,
لابد أن نكون على ما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And therefore, we have to be upon what Allah سبحانه وتعالى said.
إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت أي خافت قلوبهم.
We have to be upon the example that which Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, that indeed the believers, they are only those people when they are reminded of Allah, wajilat qulubuhum, their hearts tremble with fear.
وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا.
And when the verses or the ayat of Allah are read or recited to them, then their iman it increases.
وَلَابُدْ مِنَ الْإِنْكَارِ عَلَى كُلْ مَنْ يَحْدُثْ مِنْهُ شَيْءٍ مِنْ هَذَا سَبْ لِلْرَبْ أَوْ لِلْدِّينِ أَوْ لِلْنَبِيِّ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ.
And we have to speak against and forbid every single person who insults Allah or the messenger or the religion.
لأن الذي يسمع السب,
because the one who hears the insulting,
إما أن ينكر أو ينصرف,
either he should forbid and speak against it or move away.
إذا بقي وجلس,
as for if he remains and he sits,
ولم ينكر,
and he doesn't forbid this action,
فهو مثل السب,
then he is similar to the one who is insulting.
والدليل قول and الله تعالى,
and the evidence of this is the saying of Allah the Most High,
وقد نزل عليكم في الكتاب,
indeed he has revealed upon you in the book,
أن إذا سمعتم آيات الله,
that if you hear the verses of Allah, the ayat of Allah,
يكفر بها,
being disbelieved in,
ويستهزأ بها,
or being mocked, made a mockery of,
فلا تقعدوا معهم,
then do not sit with them,
حتى يخوضوا في حديث غيره,
except that they start talking about something else.
إنكم إذا مثلهم,
if you do not do this, then you are similar to them.
أهل الكفر,
the people of disbelief,
أرادوا,
they wanted,
إيقاع أهل الإسلام في هذا,
the people of disbelief, they wanted for the Muslims to fall into this.
صنعوا تمثليات.
So for example, they made تمثليات, cartoons or models.
يسميها هؤلاء تمثليات إسلامية.
And they call them, these people, they call them like Islamic cartoons or,
وهي في الحقيقة,
and yet in reality they are,
فيها تمثيل الكفر.
And yet in reality these type of things, they have in them examples of disbelief.
يأتي في هذه التمثيليات من يمثل دور إبليس.
So in these type of cartoons or these type of programs or these dramas where they depict Islam or the Prophet ﷺ, there comes somebody who acts as if he's Iblis.
وأبو جهل.
And somebody who acts as if he is Abu Jahl.
وأبو لهب.
And somebody who comes and he acts as if he is Abu Lahab, an actor acting the role of Abu Lahab.
في هذه التمثيليات.
In these type of cartoons or dramas.
يسب الرب.
And then because he's playing the role of Iblis or Abu Lahab, Abu Jahl, he insults Allah.
والدين.
And the religion.
والنبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
والحلف باللات والعزة.
And also he takes a vow or an oath by the false deity such as اللات والعزة.
وإذا أنكرت على هؤلاء قالوا هذا تمثيل.
And yet if you forbid those people and if you speak against those people, they say, look, these are only dramas or cartoons.
النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام قال ثلاث جدهن جد وهزلهن جد.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said three matters. When you are serious about them, it's taken seriously. And even when you jest about them, or when you do these actions lightly, or you are not in not being serious, then they're still serious.
يعني لا فرق في هذا الباب بين الجاد والهازل.
Meaning that these three matters, there's no difference between the one who does them and he does it in seriousness or out of jest or doing it lightly.
يسخر ويستهزئ بسب الرب.
A person mocks and insults Allah the Lord.
وبعض الناس يقول,
and some people they say,
نحن لا ندري أن هذا كفر.
We don't know whether this is disbelief.
سبحان الله. إذا ماذا يدري من الدين إذا لا يعلم أن سب الرب كفر, وسب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كفر, وسب الدين كفر. إذا ماذا يدري من الدين؟ هذا معلوم من الدين بالضرورة. إذا كان قلنا اليهود والنصارى يعرفوا هذا, نعم, ولا يصنعوا أصلا.
So he said, Subhanallah, glory be to Allah, if this person doesn't know that this is disbelief, if this person doesn't know that insulting Allah and insulting the messenger and insulting the religion is disbelief, then what does he know to be as disbelief? If the Jews and Christians, as we have said, if they know that insulting their Lord or their religion or their prophet is disbelief, then how is it that this third person doesn't know? Rather, this matter is an issue which is known by default, out of necessity.
نسأل الله العافية والسلام.
And we ask Allah for safety and pardoning.
نعم. ثم قال.
And then after this, the author رحمه الله, he said, The seventh matter which takes a person out of fold of Islam is a sihr, magic. And included in this are ways of turning a person away from something he loves, or swaying a person to love something either through magic. So whosoever does this or is pleased with it being done has disbelieved. Wa dalilu qawluhu ta'ala, and the evidence is the saying of Allah, they, either two angels, they would not teach this to anybody except that they would say, we are only a trial, so do not disbelieve.
Now, هذا الناقض.
So this matter which invalidates a person's Islam
هو السحر.
Is magic.
فالسحر.
So magic,
أكبر بوابة لدعوة الناس إلى الشرك بالله.
So magic is the biggest avenue for people to call other people to a shirk with Allah.
يعني أكبر دعوة اليوم.
Meaning the biggest form or the biggest avenue of calling
للشرك
to shirk
عن طريق السحر
is through magic.
كيف؟
How?
الساحر
the magician
عبد الإيمان
is a slave to whom?
عبد الإيمان
a slave to whom?
عبد عند الشيطان
he's a slave with شيطان.
فماذا يريد أن يصنع الساحر؟ يريد أن يعبد الناس عند هذا الشيطان حتى يرتفع. نعم. وما يعلمان من أحد حتى يقول إنما نحن فتنة فلا تكفر. إذا قامت عليه الحجة فالساحر يكفر ولا شك في كفره. نعم.
So the magician, he is a slave to whom? A slave to Shaytan. So therefore, what does he want through his magic? He wants other people to be slaves to Shaytan and worship Shaytan. He wants Shaytan to be elevated or higher. And this is why Allah said, وَمَا يُعَلِّمَانِ مِنْ أَحَدٍ, that they would not teach anybody this magic except that they would say to them, we are only a trial, فَلَا تَكْفُرُ, so don't disbelieve. So this was a test for them.
فالساحر يكفر.
So therefore, the magician, he disbelieves.
والدليل هذه الآية.
And the evidence is this verse, this ayah.
وقلنا أن أكبر بوابة لدعوة الناس إلى الشرك بالله عن طريق السحر.
And we said that the biggest avenue for people to call to a shirk with Allah, ascribing partners to Allah, is through magic.
كان السحر في القديم.
Magic in the olden days.
الساحر في مكان مظلم موحش في مكان نائي. عن البلدة لا يعرف أحد في الغالب إلا القليل.
So magicians in the olden days, there were people who used to, they were found in far away, dark, isolated places, away from the people. Nobody knew them. They were far away.
الآن السحر في هذه الأيام.
However, magic today in these days
دخل في أكثر البيوت.
It's in most of the houses.
كيف?
How?
قنوات تلفزيونية.
Through television channels.
قنوات الإنترنت.
Internet channels.
عبر رسائل الجوال.
Through text messages.
الجرائد المجلات.
And newspapers and columns and magazines.
وغير هذا.
And other things.
قنوات تلفزيونية للسحر خاصة.
Television channels are specific for magic.
وكذلك في الانترنت.
And also the internet.
تأتيك رسالة عبر الجوال.
A message comes through, a text message comes to you through the phone.
إذا أردت أن تعرف هل حظك سعيد أم لا ارسل لنا رسالة فيها اسمك.
And this text message will say that if you want to know whether your life or your luck is good or bad, then send us a text message with your name.
إذا أرسلت لهم رسالة فيها اسمك.
If you send a text message to these people with your name,
مجرد أن ترسل الرسالة لا تقبل لك صلاة 40 يوم.
As soon as you have sent this message with your name, then your prayer is not accepted for 40 days.
تستقبل الإجابة.
If you then receive the reply,
كفرت بما أنزل على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Then you have disbelieved in that which is revealed to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
في ثواني.
In seconds.
شراء المجلة التي فيها أبراج.
To buy a magazine or a newspaper which contains horoscopes
محرم.
Is impermissible.
النظر في الأبراج,
looking at the horoscopes,
لا تقبل له صلاة 40 يوم.
Just by looking at them, then the prayer is not accepted for 40 days.
إذا صدق,
if however a person believes his horoscope,
كفر بما أنزل على محمد,
then he has disbelieved with that which was revealed upon the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قد لا يصدق في الوقت الحاضر أول ما يقرأ.
A person, he might not believe what he reads in the horoscopes at that time initially.
لكن يصدق بعد أيام يحدث له شيء مما قرأ في هذه الأبراج.
But maybe after a few days, if something happens or occurs that which was found or described in the horoscopes, then he believes in it.
يقول هذا الذي قرأت.
So then he says that, look, this is what I read.
حدث لي كما قال.
It's happened to me exactly as it was mentioned in the horoscope.
كفر بما أنزل على محمد.
كفر. He has disbelieved in that which was revealed upon Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قراءة الكف.
Reading the palms.
الفنجان. الفنجان القهوة.
Yeah, those cups. Cups. Yeah, cups.
طيب. فنجان القهوة يقرأ منها يقول أن يحدث كذا وكذا.
So there's certain type of magic in place that occurs when they read something from a coffee cup.
النظر في النجوم.
Looking at stars or astrology.
أن لها علاقة بالحادثة الأرضية.
That you think that the stars or astrology has an effect upon those things which take place on the earth.
فلان يموت أو يحدث كذا أو كذا.
That a person he dies or this happens.
سؤال الكهان وإتيان الكهان وغيرهم.
Going to the fortune tellers or asking them.
فمن تعلم السحر.
So the person who learnt magic.
أو رضي به.
Oh, he's pleased with magic.
فهذا أتى بناقض من نواقض الإسلام وهو مرتد. والساحر في الشريعة يقتل ولا يستتاب. يقتل لكن من السلطان. نعم.
So the person who learned some magic or is pleased with magic, then this person has disbelieved or this person has committed a matter which makes him an apostate outside the fold of Islam. As for the magician, then his punishment according to Islam is that he is killed and he is not even sold, even and he's not even asked for repentance. And this is right of the rule of the Sultan.
كيف نعرف الساحر؟
So how do we know a magician?
لا يأتي بالرقية الشرعية.
That the magician, he doesn't come with the ruqya of the sharia, and the ruqya meaning the incantations that people read, he doesn't bring them from the sharia.
فالرقية تكون من الكتاب والسنة.
So the ruqya, the correct ruqya is from the Quran and the Sunnah.
فهذا يرقي بشيء ليس لا من كتاب ولا من سنة.
So this person he recites incantations from that which is not found in the Quran or the Sunnah of the Prophet.
يتكلم بكلام غير مفهوم.
Or he says or he utters words that aren't understood.
يتمتم. يعني هكذا ما تفهم ماذا يقول.
Meaning he just mumbles certain speech that you don't understand.
يخوفك.
Or he makes you scared.
يجعلك تعتقد فيه أن هو المؤثر بذاته.
Oh, he makes you believe that he is the one who has control or influence himself in his own self.
يقول انتبه ترى الدواء عندي ولا أحد يقدر على هذا إلا أنا.
So, for example, one of the ways of knowing the magician that he'll say to you that be careful, the cure to this is only with me. Only I have it, nobody else has it.
النظر في النجوم.
And also looking at stars, astrology.
كتابة حروف مقطعة ألف سين كاف ها هكذا.
Again, the ways in which you know the magician is that he will write in letters, separate letters on a piece of paper, ألف سين ها تا.
العقد مع النفث.
And then at the same time, making knots in strings and then blowing over them.
يعني يعقد وينفث.
Somebody who makes a knot and then he blows over it.
ومن شر النفاثات في العقد.
Like us in the Quran, from the evil of those people who blow over the knots.
الصرف بأن يصرف المرأة عن الرجل والعطف بأن يجعل المرأة تحب رجل أو زوج أو كذا.
Another way in which you can know a magician is that he turns a man or a woman away from his or her partner even though there's love between them, or that he makes the man and the woman love each other and then there's no love there.
ادعاء علم الغيب.
The one who claims the knowledge of the unseen, علم الغيب.
ادعاء ما في الضمير.
Or he claims to know that which is inside.
يقول أنت تحب فلانة.
He says that, look, you love this woman.
أو ادعاء معرفة الشيء المفقود يعني الضالة. كان فقد فق يعني مثلا ضل عنه يعني ولد أو متاع أو كذا.
Or somebody who claims to know where that thing is that you've lost. So for example, if somebody's lost a child or some possession, then this person claims to know where it is.
والله أعلم.
And Allah knows best.
نعم نراجع ما أخذنا ثم نكمل إن شاء الله تعالى بعد صلاة العشاء.
So let's revise that which we have taken and then we will complete after Isha prayer.
ماذا أخذنا?
So what have we taken so far?
بعد المغرب.
After المغرب.
نعم. لا شيء.
Nothing.
نعم.
تفضل. Regarding someone who rules by other than the laws of Allah.
الذي يحكم بغير ما أنزل. أخذنا أن الحكم بغير ما أنزل الله لابد فيه من تفصيل.
We said or we learned that with regards to ruling by other than the laws of Allah, then there is some detail in this matter.
إذا اعتقد.
If a person believes.
أن حكم القوانين.
That the laws or the man-made laws.
أو الطواغيت.
Or the laws of the طواغيت, the false deities.
مثل حكم الله. مساوي.
Are equal to the rule of the law of Allah.
أو أحسن.
Or better.
أو أن حكم الله لا يصلح.
Or if somebody believes that the laws and the rules of Allah, they're not appropriate.
إذا اعتقد هذا فهو كفر كفر أكبر.
If a person believes this, then he's a disbeliever with major disbelief.
الثاني إن اعتقد أن حكم الله يجب أن يطبق لكن قدم القوانين والطواغيت لهوى في نفسه فهذا كفر دون كفر أي كفر أصغر.
But if a person believes, meaning he has the belief that the rule of Allah, it is better and more appropriate. But he gives preference to the man-made laws or the other laws, due to a desire in his heart or due to wanting some type of leadership, then this is kufr, this is disbelief, however a minor form of disbelief.
وكذلك قلنا في هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And we also said this regarding the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
أن أكمل الهدي هو هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
That the most perfect and complete of guidance is the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
لا يمكن أن يأتي أحد بعبادة مثل ما تعبد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لأنه قال عليه الصلاة والسلام أما إني أخشاكم لله وأتقاكم لله بل شهادة الإخلاص فيها وأشهد أن محمدا عبده وصف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بالعبودية في أعلى مقامات الرسالة أعبد الخلق هو عليه الصلاة والسلام نعم.
And also the same can be said for the guidance of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. That there is no guidance which is more perfect and more complete than the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So if somebody comes and tries to bring about a worship that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't worship with, rather when we say ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh, when we say that we testify that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is a slave and the messenger of Allah,
أعبد الخلق.
Then this shows that he is the most worshipping of creation.
أعبد الخلق وعبد كذلك ليس له شيء من خصائص الربوبية.
So this means when we say عبده, that the Prophet is a slave of Allah, this means that he is the one who worshipped Allah the most and the best, and at the same time that he is a slave and he is not to be worshipped.
نعم. العبودية هنا تتضمن أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم هو أعبد الخلق.
So the meaning of عبودية here, i.e. the fact that the Prophet is a slave, is number one, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the best of worshippers,
وعبد,
and that also he is a slave,
لا يعبد,
and therefore he isn't worship.
ليس له شيء من خصائص الربوبية.
He has nothing from the characteristics of a ربوبية.
نعم, فتح الله عليك. بعد هذا من النواقض.
After
نعم.
This,
if somebody hates what the Prophet wrote with them and shared Allah, even if they perform that, for example, a salah, if he doesn't like it, then that's.
نعم. إذا أبغض شيء قليل أو كثير من الشريعة ولو عمل به كفر. إذا لابد أن تحب كل ما جاء في الشريعة وانشرح صدرك لها ولا تضيق أبدا. فتح الله عليك. Now,
if a person, as a brother mentioned, may he be blessed, if a person, he hates or detests something which is found in the Sharia, even though he might perform the action. Like the brother mentioned, for example, somebody who prays, and yet he hates the prayer. So, the Shaykh said that you have to love everything which the Sharia has come with. And your chest has to feel open and welcoming to everything and delighted at everything which is contained in the Sharia.
نعم غيره.
Anything else?
أنا الذي يعرف.
Raise your hands if you know.
فتح الله عليك.
آمين.
الاستهزاء.
Mockery.
سب الدين.
Insulting the religion.
وسب الرب.
And insulting the Lord.
سب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Insulting the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هذا أعظم الكفر.
This is from the biggest forms of disbelief.
نعم.
Yes.
وقلنا هذه المسألة خطيرة جدا.
And we said that this issue is very, very dangerous.
والذي يسمع السب والاستهزاء إما أن ينكر أو ينصرف.
And the person who hears of this insulting and mockery, either he forbids it and he speaks against it, or he moves away.
إن لم ينكر أو ينصرف فهو مثل ومثل السب.
And if he doesn't forbid or speak against it, or he doesn't move away, then he is similar to them in their disbelief.
نعم بعد هذا.
After this.
نعم. السحر. فالساحر يكفر أم لا؟ يكفر. ما الدليل؟ وما يعلمان من أحد حتى يقول إنما أنحن فتنة فلا تكفر. نعم فتح الله عليك.
So the brother mentioned sihr, magic, and the sheikh said that magic, does the person disbelieve or does he not disbelieve? Yes, he disbelieves. And what is the evidence? The saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they would not teach magic to the people except that they would say that we are a test, so do not disbelieve.
الله أعلم أن نكتفي بهذا المقدار. تراجع ما أخذنا ونكمل إن شاء الله تعالى بعد صلاة العشاء. وصلى الله على نبينا